Who I was to prove. Well, good evening, Vegas. How are you this evening? Have you had a good day so far? How many of you gambled? How many of you won something? Not bad, not bad. How many of you lost something? Good, good, but it wouldn't be Vegas if that didn't happen. Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to Eric. Eric, say hello to all of you. Now, what a year this week has been. Fuck me. That's all I'm going to say because, first of all, it's March and it's not November. Obviously, you were all supposed to be here together in March. I cannot apologise enough. I'm only going to do it once. I cannot apologise enough for the inconvenience of being sick and having to delay these shows. But secretly, I'm pleased about it because this is my 95th show here tonight. And I only have five left. I have five left, five shows left, and two weekends after this weekend. And it has been absolutely wonderful to have been here. And I am glad I did some huge shows in Europe in the summer, and it was wonderful and I loved it. But I'm really, really glad that we are ending this era, as you say, here in this room, because I love it here so much. So I'm secretly glad that we're here together in November, even though for you, I know that's a massive pain in the ass. So thank you for still coming, those of you that were due to come in March. I appreciate that very, very much. Woo! How many of you have seen this show before? Woo! And how many of you have not seen this show before? Well, thank you very much. Thank you everyone for coming. That's a very high compliment for you to have come back. For the rest of you, I imagine a lot of these would be Christmas presents for you, no? Because these two kids... Do we have any Christmas presents here tonight? Ho, ho, ho! Do we have any anniversaries here? Happy anniversary. Do we have any birthdays? Happy birthday. Do we have any very belated birthdays? Happy belated birthday. Do we have any Hindus, bachelorette parties? Do we have any of those? We have one, ladies and gentlemen, over there. Good luck. Do we have any divorce parties here? We have a very proud one over here. We have a couple. Oh, look at that. Divorcees! They're in the house. Lovely jubbly. Do we have any mothers and their kids? Mothers and their daughters, mothers and their sons. I love every cat, every bit, that is my favourite, just because I really hope my kid will always want to go and see things with me when I'm older and he's older. Do we have anyone who has come here on their own? Okay, that is a nice handful. That is wonderful. I couldn't possibly keep saying wonderful if I tried, could I? I think I've said it about 100 times since I've come on the stage. I used to go to shows all the time on my own when I was younger, and I loved it. I often enjoyed it more than I did when I was with other people. So thank you for coming on your own. I appreciate that. I hope you have a good night. And do we have, it's fine, I will not be offended. This is my second favourite category that I like to ask. Do we have anyone here? Well, first of all, do we have any girls' trips? Okay. And do we have any gays' trips here?
Okay.
Which brings me to my question, mainly, I imagine, for the straight men who are in here. Do we have anyone that has been dragged against their will? Yes, it's fine. It's fine. It doesn't offend me. I love it because I'm going to make it my mission tonight to win you over. It's not going to take a lot, though, because you will get laid. You are going to get laid. Yes? By being a good sport and coming here, but also, in case you haven't heard all of my music, it is love-making music. She's going to go through a roller coaster all night, and she's going to be horny later. So you'll be thanking me later, and you'll be my biggest fan. Yes, you will. Well, anyway, welcome one and all. As I said to you, we're very, very close to the end of this. It's getting very, very bittersweet, because it's been a very, very long time, and I really have... I've grown so much as a person in the last sort of 2-3 years. And obviously I was supposed to start here 3 years ago, but we won't talk about that because, you know, that was a fucking shit show. But once we did get it off the ground, it's just been incredible. And having the stability of knowing I can do this show every weekend and knowing exactly where it is and what to expect from it has just given me so much time to really bloom and blossom in my real life. So I know it's a lot. It really has. It has really helped helped me so much in the things that I've had to get done. So it's very, very bittersweet. I'm ready for it to end, but in a beautiful way, you know, not as in like, fuck this is fucking shit, nothing like that. It's time for me to move on to the next season of my life, and I'm excited about it. I'm very, very excited about it. So thank you for being part of one of these very, very bittersweet shows. So we have done, it's 5 weekends this last little run, and we have done 5 shows now. That's right. Today, this is the 5th show of the 10 shows that I have left, and 5 is my lucky number. So this is my 5th, and then I only have 5 left, so we're in a really, really good space number-wise. You know, I'm obsessed with numbers, 19, 21, 25, 35, you know. It's my thing, so yeah, I like leaning into that. And I'm going to give you the best possible show that I can, as I always do. And I would like you, I know it's hard, I mean, the world is always noisy, but obviously this week it's very, very noisy, and everything that's happening in the world is still happening outside of those doors, right? And it's still going to be happening in 2 hours' time when you leave. So let's all agree just to switch off while we're in it, have fun, pretend it's March. And just be present, because I am about to drag you head first through all of your old historical emotional grief, head first through your own mud. And I've been doing this such a long time now, it's probably before you even cared what was happening in the world. So let's just revisit that, because the minute you step out there, it's going to be really, really noisy again. I'm going to try my hardest to make you laugh and give you whiplash for the next 2 hours. I make you cry, I make you laugh. I do revel in trying to make people laugh. So I'll be trying to do that. But just let's just have a giant karaoke night together. I sing, you sing, we sing. And we're going to have the time of our lives. And for those of you that haven't seen it, the show is very much a grower and not a shower. So I know it looks incredibly intimate right now. Obviously, it's an intimate room, but the stage looks a little bit beautiful, but basic. But trust me, it does a lot of things. So I'm going to give you every possible element of a show that I can. I love this show. It's my favourite show I've ever done. I really, really bled into it. Obviously, there's a lot of piano ballads in the show. Let's not pretend that's not true. So I'm going to do a couple more piano ballads in this setup, and then I'll be doing lots more for you throughout the night. There is a moment where I'm going to give you 3 up-tempo pop songs, like, you know, little bangers. But I'm going to give you those all together, and we'll get them out of the way, because we don't lie to ourselves, do we? That's not who we are. Certainly who I am. It's not what we're here for tonight, is it, at all? But I will give them to you. Don't worry about that. So this song is off of my second album, and it's actually, that whole album is very serious sounding, and it was serious. It was my first real heartbreak, but this song was inspired by an argument that I had at a Chinese restaurant. It's true. And it's about, I kind of really incorporated a Lazy Susan table into the title of this song. You know the Chinese restaurants where the tables turn? Yes, it's after one of those. We were having an argument at a Chinese restaurant in New York, and it pissed me off that he put his hand on the Lazy Susan and wouldn't let me get my food. But it produced this song, so take it away. Here we go.
God only knows what. so sad.
Finished a season of flag football. I have no fucking idea what that is. I go to every game. I'd never miss a game. I would never ever miss a game. He does every sport. He's just a good team player, you know. He likes to be with his friends and things like that. Obviously, I know what's going on with football, like soccer, you know. I don't know why you call it soccer. I guess, I don't know, but you know what I mean, football. I go to that basketball I get, thank God, for my fiancé. Imagine if I didn't like basketball and I was about to marry an agent. That'd be crazy. I love basketball, I can do that. I don't understand flag behind football. I don't understand it. I've been to every game, I'm there like a soccer mum and whatever that is and things like that. I have no idea what's going on. But I made it to the end of the season. I can't even tell what child is my child or what child is my child. They wear those cocoon things on their head, which I'm very pro about. You should all wear cocoon things on your head. And then they wear flags, like, you know, like they're in Hawaii. So I just have no idea who is who or what's going on. But I'm very, very much in my soccer mum era. Obviously with the flag football and the basketball and baseball, there's lots of things going on. I don't know what, is that just a sports mum? What kind of mum is that? Soccer mum, yeah. What? Minivan. Let me get myself a minivan. It was her idea. No one can tell me no now. I mean, some lady said it. Neighbours. Gonna get the minivan. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay. So anyway, that's what I've been doing this week. There's no more games left. I think they do basketball next. So thank God I know what's going on with that. But I survived the flag football. It started before I came back. So I've been talking about it every week. And there was two games this week. Mondays, I'm very, very bedraggled because I get home very, 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 very early on Sunday morning rather than very late on Saturday. and I look like a truck has hit me, and normally I go on to vocal rest for a couple of days, mainly, sometimes I need it, sometimes I pretend I need it, so that I don't have to talk to anybody. And actually, again, on the Monday, I think I looked like, I don't know, I look like the woman that lives in the park in Home Alone 2. I looked crazy, but I was a good sport. I turned up, never going to miss a game, never ever going to miss a game. Anyway, I'm going to do now for you the first song that I wrote for the second album that I was just telling you about. And I'd also like to let you know that I am the biggest drama queen in the world, okay? And I lean into it now that I'm getting older. I'm 37 soon, so well, I'm 36 and a half. But I like saying I'm 37 soon because I love it. The older I get, I love it. I love it. I love myself. I get more patience. I enjoy life the older I get, and I absolutely am loving it. So that's why I lean towards 37. I used to make the biggest deal out of, I still do, but I wrote, my second album is the most dramatic fucking thing I've ever done in my life. And I meant every single word of it, and I didn't realise how dramatic I would be. I was saying last week, I don't know why I was talking about my first album last week, but my first album was mainly about one person also, not the same person that 21 was about, but I realised last week I don't even remember his fucking name.
Oh my god, I love it.
Ian on 21, I do remember his name because that was my first like proper relationship. We lived together, we had the same friends. It was like a complete like dismantling of like, well, they, you know, this person can't be my friend and that person can't be your friend. It was pathetic, but you know, that's what happens in life. But obviously, I went on to write an album about it, and then you know. What would have happened if my 21-year-old self was about to know that I was going to get divorced in a few years? What would have happened? I'm just so very, very dramatic. And the one time I'm the biggest heartbroken I've ever been with my marriage ending, it's quite a loving album. There's no angry songs on it or anything like that. But I guess that is self-growth. I guess that is getting older, and that's what comes with that. This next song that I'm going to do for you, which was the starter of me being so very, very dramatic with 21, I was very lucky that I was able to travel somewhat with my first album, with the, you know, the one about the guy, I don't remember his name. And very, very lucky to come to America. And I know that doesn't sound like a big deal necessarily nowadays. Obviously, for the majority of people in this room, you will know that that is a big deal because I wasn't a streaming artist. I wasn't, social media didn't even really exist when I first came out. I was a MySpace artist, but that was as far as it went, you know? And so it's not instant that you can have any kind of audience anywhere, really, back in the day, of where you might be able to go and actually like be a singer. So I was very, very lucky that I got to do some TV and things like that over here in America, and I got to tour pretty extensively, not like big arena tours and things like that, but you know, I got to do amazing clubs and amazing theatres and really, really travel around. And sorry. I'm drunk. I'm not drunk, don't worry. I'm a bit deaf in my left ear, I've had an ear infection. Say it again. Arizona, I did go to Arizona quite a few times. Yes, I did. Oh, we have a few people from Arizona. Well, hello, we're only around the corner, aren't you, really? Anyway, be careful shouting things out, because one time I thought someone was saying that pride sucks, and that man, poor man, went viral. So be careful shouting things out, because I might not understand what you're saying. I'm still convinced you said pride sucks, though. I'm still convinced you didn't say work sucks. But you know, it's up for debate, whatever. I don't even have social media, so I wouldn't even know. But all of my friends did. And some were saying he said work, some said pride. But anyway, let's just move on from that subject. It's a bit heavy this week, isn't it? And put me back in.
tripping on my mind. I grow
thunder every day, lose myself in time. Just thinking on your face, God only knows why it's taking me so long to let my doubts go.
I love her. That's like, I one of my so songs. Love her.
Oh my God, I can't. Woo!
Thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.
Now it's time for my favorite part of the show. I know, and it's terrible because it has nothing to do with singing. It has nothing to do with music. It is time for my t-shirt guns. So I started doing, hang on, bit background. I started doing these years ago, like 7-8 years ago, in like massive outdoor stadiums, parks, cricket grounds and things like that. Because I was like, well, this can't be real, being in front of this many people. How can I connect with the people that I can't see? Now, I'm not talking about you. I can see your eyeballs up there. This room is the perfect, perfect size. I love it. I'm comfortable with everything in here. But in those big, like, big sporting rooms, I feel like SpongeBob or something like that, you know? So I was like, fuck it. Seeing as I'm playing these massive sports rooms, let me be my own mascot and I'll start shooting t-shirt guns. No. Obviously, I wasn't going to do it in here because this is way, way smaller, but it's just too much fun, so I carried on doing it. So I'm going to be aiming at the balconies and floor. Don't touch me. You will see why I'm aiming for the balconies, because this is a very powerful t-shirt. I will bump your head off. No doubt someone will sue me for an injury. But sometimes I overshoot my shot. So don't fall asleep on me, floor, okay? Because the last few weeks, every other one has been landing and popping on your heads. Okay, so here we go. Top balcony first. Are you ready? There is a signed t-shirt, handwritten note for 50 bucks. 50 bucks, say 50,000 bucks. 50 bucks to go buy myself a treat. Lovely. Okay. Middle balcony, are you ready? I have four. Okay, middle balcony. Now this one's harder, okay? I overshot the shot, fuck. Hang on. I've got two more around the other side. Hang on, sorry little girl, okay, I overshot it. Okay. It's very powerful, I told you. When I just did my summer shows, I walked over one of my fans. The air fans, not a person, don't worry. When I did my huge summer shows, it was huge, it was wild. They built me, how do I say this word without it sounding aggressive? Say it, Joe. Ferris wheel, my t-shirt guns. He thought I was quite a Ferris wheel. You couldn't pay me to build a Ferris wheel. I got stuck up there when I was a kid, don't like it. Basically, I did my t-shirt guns in Munich, and it wasn't just these single ones that you hold. They built me a whole machine full of t-shirt guns. It just went boop, 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 and shot out like 25 at a time. But you know what? It was fun, but they weren't as good as these ones. No, they weren't. Back row. Nice one, I saw that. Right, middle back row, come on. Got it. Perfect. Fucking perfect. Absolutely great. It's harder because the opening is smaller. Okay, there we go. Right, let me grab your hot honey. In it dry in Vegas today. Have you not felt it? Oh my God. I had to keep reapplying my hyaluronic theorem or whatever it's called. My face is so thirsty. Let me just check this fan is off, otherwise it's going to be all right. Okay, hello. You look so glamorous. My God.
Oh my God.
Whose seat did I actually call out? Hello, sir. What is your name? Yeah. Andy. Oh, Ed, sorry, hang on, you put me drink down, take both of my ears out. Ed, okay, Ed, you look so glamorous, I can't get over it. And who are you here tonight, Ed? Hello, wife, Kathy, and where have you guys come from? Austin, Texas. Love Austin, Texas. Are you from, I mean, are you both originally from Austin, Texas? Well, how long have you been there? A long time. Where are you originally from? From Ohio, where are you from? Are you both from Ohio? I like to think of myself as an Ohio honoree. My partner, yes, he's from Ohio, so I love a bit of Ohio, I guess I do. I can't say I've been all over. I've only been to Cleveland and Columbus. I know there's obviously a lot of places. And how long have you guys been in Vegas? When did you guys get here?
Thursday.
Oh, hang on a minute. So you've been here for a day or so already. What have you done? Just had dinner. So you had dinner yesterday. Pardon? Billy Joel tomorrow night. Where's he playing? See, of course he's playing the Allegiant. Billy Joel's fucking great, isn't he? Do you know, if there's ever, obviously, I know all of his songs, but if there's ever a great song and I'm like, who is this? It's always Billy Joel. Every great song, I mean, I know all of his catalogue, but if you're like, I know this song, who is it? It's all, a great, great song is always written by Billy Joel, is what I've always found. And so what do you guys, so that show is tomorrow. Okay, do you have any plans for after this show? You're going to go to the club? There we go. Oh, I love that. I love it. I've never gambled. I think I'd be terrible at it. I think I'd lose everything. Now, you look very, very glamorous. I can't actually get over the look. I wish she's like a shining ball and he's in a velvet suit and like a suede velvet shirt as well. I know. I know. Something a bit shy. I know. But look, you look absolutely incredible. And then when are you guys going home to Austin? Okay, so what are you doing on Sunday? I know I'm being nosy. It's just I don't really meet strangers very often, so I revel in it. You are booked and busy. Now tell me, why did you guys move to Austin however many years ago it was?
We moved up when the country shut down
for
the pandemic from Dallas to Austin
for Israel. Oh, okay, so I thought you said that you've been in Austin for 18 years. Oh, in Texas for 18 years. Oh, so you moved to Austin during COVID. And how long have you guys been together? You can lie if you want. Woo! 51 years you've been together and married for 47. Well, you two look like you still have a great fucking time together, so congratulations. And yeah, I kind of want to be a bit like you guys when you're older. I really, really do. Okay, so well, this is the part. I'm so glad that I called you down because, and you've been together for 51 years because this song is absolutely perfect for you then. This song is for you both. Thank you so much for coming to my show and thank you for being so fun. Have fun at Billy Joel, have fun at Michael Jackson, have fun. I've been to the Diana exhibition, not here in Vegas, but I think it's the same one. It travels and it's
God, she's so pretty.
So you have a lot of fun. This is Make You Feel My Love.
Thank you.
Hug your arms and your hands.
Brazil.
This is hometown. I'm gonna go home.
Okay.
Not enough.
There are no tears.
Have another sip.
like, God damn it.
I got more.
I just swallowed my cap.
I have more though.
Dang it.
Woo!
feel how hot that flame is.
Oh my God, stop! You're right here!
Always sung this next song, Walking Through the Crowd. Just how intimate it is and safe it is, you know, to some degree. Sometimes we get people who are a little bit overexcited, but you know, more often than not, I feel safe as anything in here, whereas it'd be very, very hard for me to do something like this in a very, very big room. It went in an outdoor room, is what I mean. And I used to talk away with people in the aisles and things like that. And often people would cry, and we would exchange bodily fluids. Mine being sweat, theirs being tunes. And I kept getting ill, not gonna lie, sorry. I kept getting sick all the time. Obviously, being in one place for 2 years, I also have a child, and children, as much as they are wonderful, they are disgusting. They don't use hand sanitizer the way that I do. Everything always seems to go in their mouths, even as teenagers. And I found myself getting more sick more often than I did when I was on tour. And I can't do my job if I'm sick. I can't perform for people. So I'm no longer doing that. No offense, doesn't mean I don't love you, just doesn't mean you're carrying a load. And I used to ask them what one of their favorite memories was from when they were younger. And the memories would vary dramatically. A lot of grandparents, a lot of beaches, a lot of learning to ride bikes. Those were the quick first memories. Sometimes there would be a repeat offender who'd been to the show before and who had managed to think of the deepest memory they possibly could. And those ones I still remember to this day, even though I'm on show 95. And then sometimes people would be completely stuck and, you know, stuck in the moment, wouldn't know what to say at all. I would then in turn give one of my memories from when I was younger, but I'm not going to lie, I've run out of good ones. And I've 90 memories, I stopped at 90 good memories. It's hard to wrap my brain over them, but also I'm a very naturally sad, pessimistic person. Again, I fully embrace these days. Part of who I am.
I want you to know that. There's
and I don't want to be a Debbie Downer of these shows and give you traumatic sort of PTSD memories from my childhood.
What?
Me and one of my closest friends, we created a conversation card game. I'm sure lots of you have done other ones, but there's lots of different varying ones. And because we had the deepest conversations every time we see each other, which is pretty much every day. And we were like, we should write these game ones though, let people play this as a game, you know, so we decided to do that. And so I decided to start putting myself on the spot and then asking myself, picking one of the cards, let's see what on the odds of Jane, I'm going for this one. And putting myself on the spot, even though I wrote it, it's been years since we did it, and we were so drunk, so. and answer it on the spot. So it comes in different categories. So this one is, who am I? Is in the eye to the soul. What compliment has meant the most to you? Aww. I need a minute, see, it's not planned, so can I have a second one more time? What compliment? What compliment the most? Mm-hmm. Probably it's about my son.
Aww.
That was a hard one. Shit, what compliment has meant the most to me? And probably, gosh, I don't know. Raven, I probably told you one of. I probably told you what means the most to me. It's like the one about the
compliment.
Being authentic! Oh, the great mum one feels obvious though. Is that one feels? Or maybe it's not. I guess not all mums are great. But I'm not the greatest mum. I still have one of my fault.
Angelo is so lucky!
Bad idea. I am a great mum, but I'm also a chaotic mother. And I think I'm a narcissist. I'm coming to realise that. But at least I know. I see that as a positive thing. I've never seen any mother. I don't think it is being a mum. It's not. No one's ever said that to me. If they have, I haven't believed them. Yes, I know what it is. I know what it is. Just how self-aware I am, and that I know myself better than anyone else in the world knows me. The greatest compliment, or I don't know if it's compliment, but remark that was ever made to me, truly was, I'm not just saying this because I'm here with you in Vegas, when I pulled the original Vegas show I was supposed to do, I was like, if I do this show, not this one, I love this show, like I said, it's my favourite show ever, if I do this show, I will never step foot on stage again, because I can't go and do something that I don't believe in or I don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And my manager said, I think it's the right thing to do. Because that's what you want to do. And I think my manager is my favourite person and my least favourite person in the world. They're very, very close. He's been looking after me since I was 18. And anything he says to me is always the best compliment, because he lets me always do things how I want to do them. And it's been 17 years now.
Yeah.
That was a hard one. See, I'm going to put myself on the spot for you guys. Thank you, Raven, for leading me there. Anyway, so on that note, this is when we were young. But I appreciate you, sir. I don't mind saying I'm the best mum. I appreciate that. So many sparkles tonight.
Everybody loves the things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move.
Yeah.
Oh, how do I feel stuck by this moment? don't forget me.
Determines ours. A great crowd is what makes a great show, and you've been amazing, and I think we all fucking deserved it this week. Did a great time.
Yes!
I can't thank you enough for taking the time and making the effort pretty much twice, because I know for the majority of people in here, we were supposed to be together in March. Like I said at the top of the show, I know it's such a pain in the ass coming to see someone all the way in Vegas when they're doing a residency, but like I said, this room has been my ride or die best friend for nearly 2 whole years now. And it is exactly what the doctor ordered, and I'm so happy and so grateful that you've been a part of one of those shows. I appreciate it so very, very much. It does not go past me how much effort and organising this takes. I appreciate it so much. I've got 2 more songs for you, including 1 more up tempo. Can you believe it? I love you all, I appreciate you all, and I will see you all on the other side, whenever that may be, definitely when I'm a bit older and wiser, because every year I keep getting older and wiser. Look after each other on the way out, be nice to each other and be patient, okay? I love you all very, very much. This is Rolling in the Jinx. it, then you're gonna do it, and we're all gonna do it together.
It's inevitable.